Good morning everybody and welcome to the first video of a new series about Xamarin. My name is Alessandro del Sole, I'm a Microsoft MVP for the Visual Studio and Development Technologies category. I'm a Microsoft Certified Professional and Programming Specialist for C Sharp. I'm a community leader of the Italian Visual Studio Tips and Tricks community, and I've been a long time author of books and technical articles, and also I wrote a number of ebooks for the Succinctly series from Syncfusion. You can find me on Twitter at progalex. So what is Xamarin? Xamarin is a technology that allows you to build native iOS, Android and UWP applications using C#. This means you can build applications for different operating systems and different kinds of devices using a familiar language, especially if you have a .NET background. With Xamarin, you are not limited to build applications for devices such as mobile phones or tablets. You can also build applications for new kinds of devices such as wearables or TVs. This is possible because Xamarin can access all native APIs that any operating system exposes from your C# codebase. Also, Xamarin allows you to share code that is not platform specific, so there are some particular situations in which you can write C# code once and reuse it across different projects for different operating systems. Last but not least, and possibly this is one of the biggest benefits of Xamarin development, is that you can reuse your existing .NET skills. In fact, not only you can use C# to code your mobile applications, but also you will use familiar development environments. Xamarin has an offer that consists of a number of products: the Xamarin Platform, the Xamarin University, the Xamarin Test Cloud, and the Xamarin Insights, which is currently transitioning to the Visual Studio Mobile Center. We will dip into each in the next slides. Let's start by talking about the Xamarin Platform. This provides all the developer tools, the platforms, and the libraries you need to build applications for Android, iOS, and Universal Windows. More specifically, the Xamarin Platform is made of the Xamarin Android, which is a set of libraries and tools that provide access to the native APIs for the Android operating system, Xamarin iOS and Xamarin Mac, which allow you to build applications for the iOS and macOS operating systems, Xamarin Forms, which is an abstraction layer that allows you to share user interfaces across different kinds of projects for different operating systems by using XAML as the markup language for defining the interface and C# as the imperative code, Xamarin Studio, a development and integrated development environment which runs on Windows and Mac, and that is the place where you can build your applications. You will typically use Xamarin Studio on a Mac, but take into consideration that Microsoft is developing the Visual Studio for Mac development environment. So this is currently in preview 5 and it will be probably available in the near future. If you work on Windows, you will definitely consider Visual Studio as your development environment, and Xamarin provides integrated tools that are already included in Visual Studio 2015 and Visual Studio 2017. The Xamarin Profiler, which is an application that allows you to investigate the performance of your apps, for example, finding memory leaks or to determine where the application is spending more time. The Xamarin Inspector, another tool which allows you to analyze the behavior of the user interface while the application is running. Then we have the Xamarin University, an incredible product that offers online classes, courses, and exams that you can take in order to get a Xamarin certification as a Xamarin certified mobile developer. Next we have Xamarin Test Cloud, a cloud-based environment to perform automated tests on more than 2,000 real devices hosted on the cloud. This allows you to perform automated tests, including UI tests, on different devices with different form factors and different size and different displays and different hardware specifications, so that you can have a very precise idea of how the application will be working once you publish it to the different stores. Finally, we have the Xamarin Insights product, which is actually working in conjunction with OKApp for telemetry and analytics for your apps. OKApp is also a popular platform that developers use to distribute applications to testers, but it is also very important to mention that Xamarin Insights and OKApp are currently transitioning into the Visual Studio Mobile Center, a new cloud-based environment from Microsoft which provides analytics, build automation, backend, you can create tables for your apps in a very few steps, authentication based on the Azure Active Directory and on social network providers, and test automation and deployment to testers. How does Xamarin work? Actually, Xamarin relies on the Mono runtime, which can be considered as a cross-platform porting of the .NET technology for Mac and Linux. And this is also the reason why you can write C# with Xamarin, because the Mono runtime provides an implementation of all the libraries you need to code for different operating systems using C#. It actually offers interop C# libraries that access all the native APIs from macOS or iOS or Android. For example, with Xamarin iOS, you have libraries that access the native Cocoa framework, or in Xamarin Android, you have libraries that access the Java libraries, exposing them as C# libraries. What do I need to build applications with Xamarin? If you work on Windows, you will certainly use Visual Studio 2017. The community edition is supported and the Xamarin tools are already integrated. You can certainly use higher editions such as the Professional or the Enterprise. Also, you can use Xamarin on Visual Studio 2013 and 2015 by installing the Xamarin tools separately. You can go to xamarin.com and download the required tools. All the other required Xamarin tools are installed with the Visual Studio 2015 and Visual Studio 2017 installers. You also need some platform SDKs, for example the Google SDKs and the Windows SDKs. You might need some emulators for Android devices, emulators for Windows devices. But there are additional requirements when you want to build applications for iOS. In fact, the Apple policies require you to have a local or remote Mac computer, which is required just to compile code and build an app for iOS. On your Mac, you need to have installed the Xcode development tool, the Apple SDKs, and the Xamarin tools for Mac. Also, you will need to have Xamarin Studio or Visual Studio for Mac Preview installed on your Mac machine. I will provide you with more details about iOS development in a next video about Xamarin iOS. Luckily enough, if you use Visual Studio 2017, life is much easier because the Visual Studio installer provides a specific workload that will be responsible to install all the necessary tools and SDKs and emulators you need to build applications with Xamarin and Visual Studio. The workload is called Mobile Development with .NET. And you can find it under the mobile and gaming group. Now let me show you how you can create Xamarin applications with Visual Studio 2017 so that I can show how to get started. So here I am in Visual Studio 2017. In order to create a Xamarin application, I have to go into the New Project dialog. And then I have different choices depending on what my target platform is. For example, if I select the Android project templates, I will see a list of built-in templates that are specific to Xamarin Android. I can create a blank app, I can create a wear app for wearable devices, I can create an application that uses the Razor templating engine, I can create a game, I can create a class library, I can start with a very basic single view app with an application where the UI is made of just a single page and that is good to get started with Xamarin Android. I can also create a UI test app and a unit test application. Similarly, if I go to the iOS node, I can see different targets such as the Apple Watch with a number of templates specific for the Apple Watch, extensions for iOS, iPad, iPhone, or universal applications that run on all the supported devices. And similarly, we have templates to create a blank application, an OpenGL game, a single view application, and other templates that I will be discussing in more details in a specific video. You can also create applications for TV iOS, which is very nice. Notice the cross-platform node, which allows you to build Xamarin Forms application. Why cross-platform? Cross-platform because the user interface and the code, the C# code you write in a Xamarin Form application will certainly run on Android, iOS, and Windows devices. Xamarin Forms is actually the real cross-platform layer, and as well as for the other development tools, I will provide more details in a specific video. Whatever kind of application you create, for example, a blank Android application, you will feel at home in the development environment, as you will be able to use tools that you have always used against different kinds of application. For example, you have full debugger availability, full code editor support, including the live code analysis as you type, powered by Roslyn. As a general rule, in the standard toolbar of Visual Studio, you will be able to find a list of supported devices that you can use to run, test, and debug your application, including physical devices. And of course, I will be providing more details in the next videos. As a summary of this video, we have discussed what Xamarin is, we have seen what the Xamarin offer is, we learned how Xamarin works behind the scenes, and we have seen all the required tools that, as developers, we need to install and configure to build applications with Xamarin. In the next video, I'll be introducing Xamarin Android, and I will discuss how to build a simple application for Android with C#. Thank you so much for watching this video.